Hello and welcome back to a new review for gamers, episode 8. We had, well, I think it's pretty easy if I say we could kinda solve misunderstandings, but then shit hits the fan once again with an awesome ending, and good lord, the game they were playing a board game, which was basically the game of life, or I don't know how the name in English is, but in German we have a game that's called Spiel des Lebens, and it's basically what they played, and it was hilarious. It was a romance version of it, and yeah, in that game Aguri married Amano, and yeah, Tasuki was kinda cheating, then Karuin, she was basically going for the career, and Chiaki, she was the poor girl, didn't find a job, and yeah, she was really poor, literally poor, no money. And there were so many jokes, and all of them pointed to that situation, and you know, people say it's often better to just show things instead of saying it out loud, but we had this going on. We all knew that, well, this fits these characters. All of them. Literally, all of those four main characters, it fits them really hard. But then you have Tasuku, who was voicing it out loud in his mind and going on that this is bullshit and was making fun of it. He was literally making fun of it, how this fits those character, these fateful irony and stuff like this. And it's really what I love about gamers, even though you see all these things, you hear all their dialogues and monologues, you totally know what is going on and which direction it is going, only to have a character pointing it out in their own way, simply because that character is literally the viewer. And it comes most of the time to Tasuku, because he is literally us, or we are literally him. And it's so hilarious that baffles me every single week. And we had a new character, we had Chiaki's little sister. She's a student council president in her school. And she is a total maniac when it comes to eroge. To the point that she's dressing up and going into the adult sections of a game store to buy them. And when her other comrades or classmates or stunt council mates left, she was rubbing her cheek on the chair, pointing out the scents of pure innocent maidens. She's crazy. She's a maniac. Goddamn, we need more of her. I don't know. She seems like a great character. Yeah, sorry, I kinda do have a thing for those crazy, perverted girls in anime who are totally after other girls. Yeah, I don't know why. Don't ask me, I really don't know. But aside that, we had that game going on, it was going on for the majority of this episode. And some of those builds in that game, those events, they were hilarious. We had basically the wedding of Amano and Aguri, and Tasuku was commenting on it, going on like, yeah, they're marrying and they're happy, they love each other, stuff like this. And then it was like, oh yeah, and Tendo and I, it was hard on us to see our desires marrying away, and then pointing out, yeah, we are doing fine, but it's hard, and it was so hilarious. I mean, I was laughing, yeah, all the time of this episode. I loved every single second of it. And that game, seriously, I would play it. Simply for the fun of it. Because it's hilarious. And then we had Chiaki going out of the room, we had kind of the misunderstanding getting solved. Karin got closer to Amano while he was playing the game. His smartphone game. Basically Grand Blue Fantasy. Because it is literally Grand Blue Fantasy. Why do I know it? Because I'm playing it myself. And it's kind of addictive. It's really tough. It's really hard. It's crazy. Goddamn, I like that game. But then we also had Aguri and Tasku sitting together and being like, yeah, it's nice to see them getting closer. And then they both made clear, without saying it directly, that they are not cheating. They love each other. They were like, well, yeah, are you happy for them? And yeah, I'm as well, but I don't know. And then when Aguri was asking, well, yeah, but why are you holding my hand right now? We are in front of Karin. And he was just like, well, what about it? It doesn't matter, right? So it was really nice to see their misunderstanding getting solved. And also when Tasku asked Aguri what she thinks about Amano, it was really cool. She was like, well, yeah, he's like her little brother who you have to take care of him. He needs a lot of attention because he's kind of, well, hopeless. But now he got a great girlfriend and I think he can kind of get annoying, so kind of like this. And I really appreciated this because instead of, I'm not cheating, I like you, they were going like this, which felt way more real in terms of their love for each other than if they would just like, well, no, I'm not cheating, I like you. So yeah, I really appreciated this scene. Also, when Chiaki came back, she saw him playing that game, and while he was talking to Karin, he said, it's kind of bad without Mono. And then he said which two main nicknames he is using, and yeah, with this one I'm talking to Mono and with that one to the creator. And then Chiaki was there kind of baffled, and yeah, we now have something new. And it was really hilarious. You instantly saw that she's like, god damn it, he's my first love, even though it's kind of late now. And yeah, once again, it was spoiled by Tasku. I can't say enough how I love it, how this show is spoiling itself. And you can't even be mad about it because it's done in such a great way. So yeah, this show is fucking amazing. I love it. I can't wait for the next episode, and I'm still waiting for an announcement of the light novel license. Yen Press, come on, do your fucking thing and license it. With Classroom of the Elites, please. Thanks. But yeah, anyways, that's it for episode 8 right now. I know I'm kinda late with the reviews. We're doing a shit ton of reviews over this weekend. It will be a busy time. But yeah, as always, thanks for watching, and I hope I will see you guys next time as well. Have a great time. See you later.